So I think the opportunity for investment grade corporates in 2023 is going to be bottoms up security selection. You know, it's less about the Fed's tightening cycle and more about what companies are going to be winners and what companies are going to be losers. Volatility in the treasury market's been extremely high. If we look at the MOVE index, which is basically the bond market's equivalent of the VIX, it's at levels we haven't seen outside of a couple of days in March of 2020, all the way going back to the global financial crisis. So that's the risk-free asset, and that volatility in the risk-free asset leads to volatility in all other asset classes. So, you know, the Fed's rate hike cycle's been very aggressive. It's gone on for a very long time, and I think if people can start to see the other end of that, see across the horizon, they can start focusing on, you know, what do I do after the Fed? As we think less about a Fed pivot and more about a Fed pause, it's started to become more about dispersion and credit selection and who are the winners and who are the losers. So when the market's just driven by rate volatility, it's really, really tough. It's really hard to try to make money. But if we settle down and kind of look forward, we really feel like that's an environment that fits our strategy and fits what our research people do from a research intensity standpoint at Columbia Threadneedle Investments. People are focusing on the fact that the 10-year treasury has gone from 50 basis points in the middle of 2020 to north of 4% now. Well, over the last 15 years, the average rate for the 10-year treasury is right about where we are here at 4%. So it's different than what we've seen over the last couple of years, but it's not that different from what people have seen historically. So the higher yield environment has two impacts. Number one, from a company perspective, again, they're used to borrowing money at 2 and 3%, and now they're borrowing money at 5 and 6%. So that matters. Thankfully, companies created a lot of liquidity for themselves in 2020 and 2021. Again, in 2020, given the COVID uncertainty, companies borrowed $2.1 trillion in our marketplace. In 2021, they followed that up by borrowing $1.7 trillion. And most of that is still liquidity sitting on their balance sheets. So companies have tremendous financial flexibility. They've pushed out the refinancing wall. So, you know, the impact of higher rates is going to matter eventually, but it's not something that is worrisome right now for most companies. And then on the demand side, higher rates are awesome from the ability to put money to work for clients. Again, we were struggling with the 10-year treasury at 50 basis points and the yield of the investment grade corporate market at 1.75% at the end of 2020. Now it's north of 6%. So the ability to buy bonds for our client portfolios at north of 6%. And oh, by the way, the other nice attractive feature is the fact that dollar prices, because of that move in rates and the fact that we had so much issuance in 20 and 21 at low yields, those dollar prices now in many instances are in the 70s and the 60s. So, you know, to combine 6% yields, which we haven't seen since the global financial crisis, with dollar price discounts that we also haven't seen since the global financial crisis, when we think the fundamentals of companies are really, really strong and their liquidity is really, really good, that's exciting.